basically questioning my integrity.
When you think that you know what the right decision is, you have to act on it.
What does Willie need to do? He needs to get out of here.
I'm Irish. We're stubborn.
Wonderful advantage. Not making the playoffs 4 years in a row.
Austin Matthews.
It's just an error in judgment.
I'm not pussyfooting around like some guys.
This guy's such an idiot here.
How's it going, boys? Johnny Superb Man here, and it's finally time. NHL 21's franchise mode. We had a lot of fun last year with the Boston Bruins and the greatest dynasty I've ever controlled, the Seattle Stallions, ladies and gentlemen. It's now time to take my resume, to take my skill, and try to rebuild the dumpster fire franchise known as the Toronto Maple Leafs, ladies and gentlemen. That's right. It's been over 50 years since my Toronto Maple Leafs have won a Stanley Cup. I might not be around. I might not be on this planet when they actually win the Stanley Cup again. If I go half my life, it's over, baby. So GM Superb Man has got to head north of the border, all right? Kyle Dubas has been fired. GM Superb Man is in. I am going to rework the roster with all of these overpaid, overhyped superstars. All right, we're gonna have to make some tough decisions and get a Stanley Cup back in the city of Toronto, ladies and gentlemen. So let's start this up. I haven't even jumped into franchise mode just yet. So I am a veteran of the past, but apparently there are some new features, including the trade deadline. I want to see if there's any changes and tweaks to the simulation. So the first time through, ladies and gents, we are going to take this nice and slowly. And we also, look at this, we also have our Twitch scouts that are alongside of us. So if I have any hard decisions to make, any questions to ask the fans, I can get a real-time update. But also, I can listen to you guys in the YouTube chat as well, right? So let's start this up. We got a classic GM mode, or classic franchise mode. The name, here we go, baby. GM Superb Man. Let's throw it in there. I could throw something else, but no. We got to keep this legit. We got to keep this professional and legit. All right. No more the laughing stock of the NHL, of our Toronto Maple Leafs. GM Superb Man has the reins of the team, baby. Let's start this sucker up. So here it is, the Toronto Maple Leafs. The total team budget, $111 million. What's the cap? Player salary budget, $83 million. So we're already over the salary cap. That's going to have to be something I figure out to start the season. I don't want the game to have that weird thing that happens where it affects our salary. So I'm going to have to dump some freaking players. Our top players are Austin Matthews, Mitch Marner, and John Tavares. I wonder how long we have John Tavares before he starts dropping off in the game, right? It really is time to win right now. Austin Matthews could be gone in 5 years. Or 4 years! It's 4 years because we just had the first freaking year. So here it is. The Toronto Maple Leafs, ladies and gentlemen. The division realignment, we're not going to touch anything. No, the Seattle Kraken are not in there just yet. And I don't know if I like the Kraken name, I gotta say. It's gotta be the Stallions after what we experienced last year. Alright, so all the old features. Owner mode off, garbage. Fantasy draft is off. Salary cap is going to be on. GM firing is going to be off. Head coach edit line is going to be off. Fog of war, trash, off. Player morale, I'm not even going to get trust that it's good this year. Off. Computer trades on. Auto owner mode off. Accept relocation off. Auto sign free agents off. And auto staff management off. All right. So all these cool little features that they put in the game, only using two of them. That's right. That's what I do. And there we go, ladies and gentlemen. So let's go through the rules and settings and see what we want. I'm going to leave injuries on, and I think we can even leave them, well, maybe I'll ask the Twitch scouts, how high should the tuner settings for injuries be on? We're going to leave them on to start the series, but we can change it from there, all right? Fantasy draft is going to be off, authentic cap penalties is going to be on, auto sign free agents off, auto save, we're going to turn that sucker off, franchise mode length 25 years, computer trades on, difficulty, we're going to go to, now this is the gameplay difficulty, right? Yeah, this is not a simulation difficulty. Usually with the gameplay, I like to throw it on pro, just because when we jump into the game, I feel like Superstar, it's way crazy. So we're going to leave it on pro. If you guys want me to put it on Superstar, I will. But remember, this does not affect the simulation, which is what franchise mode is all about. This is the gameplay, and we're not going to be controlling our team whatsoever. Draft pick ownership, authentic. NHL salary cap is going to be on. Trade difficulty, we're going to leave it on... Well, I'll leave it on medium for our first playthrough. They might have made some tweaks, so I don't want to make any crazy changes just yet. Waivers are going to be on. Accept relocation off. Fog of war off. Blah, 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 blah. Auto scouting is going to be... I'm going to leave that on, actually, because I can still make the adjustments. Year number one. But the Leafs, we're not really going to be drafting too much. We need to get players and get them right now. So, we're going to put auto skating for both, and the auto staff management is going to be off. All right, so there you go. That's the quick settings. The advanced settings, things like automated goalie rotations, injury return warning playable. Give me it when he's playable. Yeah, because when the playoffs happen, remember Alexei Lafreniere game 7. Minor league head coach. What is this? This setting will determine how much the computer manages the user's minor league team. No, I can do that myself. Minor, the same thing, the injuries for the minors. Auto-rotate goalies is going to be on. Sim engine scoring. Now, a lot of people in the Twitch scouts are saying to put it on low. We're going to just play it through on medium the first time around. I do not know. Draft class quality. And this as well, this is new. We can put better players in the draft. We're just going to leave it on medium to start. All right, I want to see what happens. The generated prospect quality, we're going to leave that on medium as well. Sim engine shot frequency, we're going to leave that on medium. So I have no clue what these settings are going to do and how they influence the simulation. We're going to have to experience it together. Playoff series link, authentic. Playoff tiebreak, continuous OT. Season overtime loss, season tiebreak. Head coach firing pop-up, yep. Trade offer notification, yep. Gameplay version, the latest. Waiver notifications, yep. Retired jerseys on, blockbuster trade alert on. So there it is. That is the base settings for the upcoming series for your franchise mode. But we could also go to gameplay sliders and affect the injury occurrence. I think last year we had it on like 10. Do you guys in the Twitch scouts, do you guys think we should lower this at all? Or should I just leave it at 50-50 to start? 5? 10 to 12, really? 10 to 12? All right, so since... everyone's saying to lower it. Let's go down to 25 to start. Just because injuries get a little bit out of hand. I still want injuries to happen, just not all the time. So 25 out of 25, all right? There you go. Remember, it's a new game. They might have tweaked some of these tuners, so we got to give it a shot. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let us start up year number one with your Toronto Maple Leafs. New to franchise mode. Welcome to franchise mode. You can now interview, hire, and fire your entire coaching staff in the NHL and AHL. We could do that last year, couldn't we? Coaches have multiple effects across the mode, and combined with our scouting system, you will now have full control to build the best organization in the NHL. All right. Coaches. Now, we've had this before. Coaches have 6 attribute grades that each have their own impact to your team's success. Coaches have an impact on results, player and coach development, and line chemistry. Each coach has a unique style and scheme that you will need to watch out for when hiring a coach. All right, so no new information right there. Line chemistry. Line chemistry impacts your team's performance. Each coach has their own scheme, and every player has a preferred scheme. Match a player to a coach's scheme as best as possible to build the best chemistry. The more you fill the chemistry bar, the more impact the attribute modifier will have on the line. Player type and position also play a factor. All right, so same as last year again. Scouting accuracy. Scouting accuracy ranges from accurate to unknown. The more times you scout a player, the scouting icon will increase in brightness and fill more bars. The more bars and brighter the icon is, the more accurate information you have. Scouting accuracy applies to both professional and amateur player. All right, cool. Fog of War. Now, we don't have Fog of War on, so I'm just going to skip that. I do not like Fog of War. When to assign a scout? When you see a player with inaccurate information, you will want to say, okay, we know that, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so at least they got themselves a little bit of a tutorial for new time players for the Toronto, or not the Toronto, for franchise mode players. And here we go. So no background, no blue background to show that we are the Toronto Maple Leafs. A different look for franchise, I guess, but the same, like, window system. So, first things first, right? Let's jump right into our squad and see what we got. The contract situation. I gotta get the salary cap under control, but we gotta see what this squad looks like. Contract extensions. Alright, so I know all about this. Players wanting extensions. Blah, blah, blah. I got it, game. I will teach the fans as we go. Alright, so Harold Bluetooth in the net. We have Frederik Andersen, who is 30 years of age. Oh, look at that. He wants an extension. Alright, so how much does he want? Ooh, that's not bad. So Harold Bluetooth, I could get to like that 4-year extension to match Austin Matthews and such, and I can get him like $6 million. That's not that bad. I was thinking that Frederik Andersen might want like 7 or 8 million, right? So we'd have to think about the contract extension for our 88 overall starting goaltender. But there's no reason to get rid of him, right? Other than the fact that in previous GM modes, we have had that pattern where goaltenders don't simulate great in the playoffs for us, right? So do I want to put $7 million? 82 overall for Arundel. Yeah, 82, that's pretty good for a backup, I gotta say. What do we got in the system? In the system, we got Jack Campbell at 80 overall and Wall at 75 overall. We're actually spending some money on Jack Campbell, 1.650. I might want to trade one of these goaltenders, because what's Del Pickle getting? 0.8? Oh, hell yeah. We got to trade away Campbell for sure. We got a better goaltender as our backup, and he's much cheaper. So I can definitely free up some cap space that way. On to the blue line. And the Toronto Maple Leafs, we've got the most recent roster update as of October 17th. So yes, TJ Brody is on the squad, ladies and gentlemen. He is 83 overall. He's got himself 4 years left along with Jake Muzzin. So signing Frederik Andersen to like a 3-year extension would align everyone to that 4-year plan. The next 4 years is when we got to get this Stanley Cup done for your Toronto Maple Leafs, right? So you got Muzzin, you got Brody, you got Justin Hall signed at a pretty good contract. Rasmus Sandin, a high top 4 defenseman, already 80 overall. I like that. And Morgan Rielly, the guy that we got to run for, But it's going to be interesting. We can use Morgan Rielly for this year for sure. But next year, we'll have him, but then he's going to be in UFA, so I'm going to try to offer him a contract extension. But at 87 overall, he might want like $8, $9 million. And if he wants that, we're not going to be able to do that. We might have to trade him and use Muzzin and Brody, or move Muzzin or Brody to sign Rielly. There's a lot of decisions that we need to make on this team. What about in the system? What's Timothy Liljegren? Timothy Liljegren still has his medium elite? Hell yes. Right-handed defenseman coming up in the system, ladies and gentlemen. EA Sports has this guy heavily rated. So we got to grow him for sure. We got Bogosian. We got to sign Travis Dermott. He is an RFA right now. Offer contract. What do you want? Get him to like a 1-year deal. Keep him as an RFA, I think. Yeah, we got to keep him as an RFA. Alright, so we have some options on the blue line. Let's go back up to the main roster. Right wingers, what do we got? Mitch the Bitch, baby. $10.895 million for the next, 5 years? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years. Alright, so Mitch Marner is way up there at 90 overall. And then William Nylander, 85 overall, 6.9, just under 7 million for the next 4 years. So yeah, Wayne Simmonds, 81 overall, really nice. Let's see, in the system, Ilya Mikheyev, we got to give a contract to. How much? 1.4 million. Joey Anderson, the guy we just picked up from the Andreas Janssen trade, I believe, correct? Medium top 9, 78 overall, got to give him a contract. How much does he want? Two-way deal, perfect for him. Left wingers, Agostino, that's in the system. Let me go to the main roster. We got Zach Hyman, who's got to get a contract extension. How much does Zach Hyman want? 2 point something million. All right, we can work with that. Pierre Engvall, who's got another 1.250 for next season. Might have to think about him. Jimmy Vesey as well. And then the center core, here's where we have our studs. See, this is what scares me about John Tavares. Now, he still has his exact elite potential. He's 29, which means we have him for this year and we have him for next year. More than likely, we have him for 3 full years. But if he starts to drop after those 3 full years, this year, next year, the year after that, we only have him for 2 more years. That's not that bad. If he keeps his exact elite to like 33, 34, it'll be a really good contract, all right? There's nothing wrong with that. But if he begins to drop off right at 31, ooh, that's going to be rough. And Austin Matthews at 11.6, high elite. This guy's going to be our first liner. We got to get him going. Big Jumbo Joe Thornton, ladies and gentlemen. That's right. We edited the rosters. Jumbo is on the team. He's 82 overall. It's pretty good, man. Alexander Kerfoot. He's in there as well. 3.5, might want to move on from him. Jason Spezza at 70 overall. Malgin and Boyd. And then in the system, what do we got? Kosala, Brooks, Robertson. He's a center left wing. We want to get this guy going as well. 74 overall, 19 years of age. Medium top six. Could be a real good play for us. Medium top six, medium top six. So we do have some prospects. But realistically, it's about arranging this team in a way that we can get chemistry, but also get our big-time guns playing. So, let's go to edit lines and see what we have here, all right? If the cap doesn't go up, this team needs to have dynamite treatment. Oh, my man, trust me, that's what I'm here for. The head coach can help. No, I don't want help. So, did we get lucky with the line combinations, all right? So, first off, Austin Matthews. He is a carry-shoot-efficient balance kind of player. I need you guys to remember that because it's very important. Is Mitch Marner somebody who can play with Austin Matthews? Please, please, please. He's exactly the same. Oh, my God. All right. That is a big-time W right there. The fact that we have Mitchell Marner, a playmaker, and Matthews as a sniper, oh my God. We have a sniper and a playmaker who works out on the first line. What now, what about Willie Nylander? Nylander is a carry cycle efficient, don't block, all right? Now, what about Johnny T? Carry shoot efficient, wait a minute. I could almost get the plus five for these guys on the first line. I might be able to get a plus five on the first line if I get a coach who maxes out. The only thing that's holding them back is that I got a center play in the wing. Tavares and Matthews are both only centers, right? So if I were to get a first liner who really maxes out that, we might be able to get a first line with these three players at a plus five and just stack it up. Now, that's going to hurt our depth for sure, but that could be something crazy. All right, so for right now, let me just we're just going to patch these lines together, see what we have, all right? So Matthews, what time we got? Balance cycle, balance block. Can I get the plus three still with? Okay, so Hyman does not work with Matthews and Marner. That's not going to be a good line. Tavares, what do you do with Nylander? All right, what about like Hyman in there? Whoa! Wayne Simmonds! Well, 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 ladies and gentlemen. Wayne Simmonds on the first line gets the plus five with Matthews and Marner. This is a real good start. This is a real good start. Thank you, Dubas. All right, so what about Jumbo Joe? Carry, shoot, balance, balance. So he's actually pretty good for, like, the third line, which is really, that's perfect. Now, what can I get going alongside of Tavares and Nylander? Kerfoot? Anybody? Not really. So the problem with Tavares and Nylander, they're not really liking that second line. Fuck, man. Nylander doesn't like anything. Nylander becoming expendable, ladies and gentlemen. So we'd have to really go through all the coaches and figure out what we have. I'm going to take a look at the coaches in a second, right? But for right now, let's just keep the lines the way they are. Thornton, Kerfoot, Engvall, Malgin, Boyd, and VC. Sure. All right. Now, who do we got scratched? Nobody scratched, so I can bring people up. Defensively, Morgan Riley, what do you got? What the? What about his defensive stats? I guess it shows it on the right, but it shows it, what the? Okay, so we've uncovered our first glitch in NHL 21. When you're viewing defensemen on the blue line, for some reason it shows you their forward chemistry, all right? How far are we into this video? Like less than 20 minutes? Okay, less than 20 minutes, new game, new glitch. But the good news is that if you train your eyes over to the right side of the screen, it will show you what his chemistry is from here. So he's a hold line and a, I don't know, well, I don't know actually. It tells me what it kind of is. You suck, EA Sports. All right, so Morgan Riley, shit! Is that for every defenseman? So they just, We just don't see defense. So Jake Muzzin is a beast on the second. Wait a minute. So if I go. Okay, I'm using some 4D chess moves. What about throwing Jake Muzzin on the freaking second line? Okay. Okay, Jake Muzzin becoming the new Brent Burns. All right. He's going to bring up Tavares and Nylander. Sounds good. Now, what about TJ Brody? Where you want to play my second line? Okay. Okay, I'm starting to see how the second line can be improved here. We're going to go with Jake Muzzin. Then we'll go with Tavares. And then we'll probably put TJ Brody on the right wing. Because why the hell not, right? TJ. Oh, hell yeah. All right, so greens across the board. What if I go like Matthews down there? Oh, still don't get the pluses. I just need to get some sort of second line center to get those pluses in there. All right. So Tavares, you ain't going to work. Who else we got? Riley, where can you play? You're not really going to work out anywhere. What about Justin Hall? Justin Hall could be that second line center that we're looking for, my man. Jason Spezza, garbage. Sandin! All right, hang on a second. If I sling out Tavares, and I go with Rasmus Sandin, So Muzzin, Sandin, and Brody have the same chemistry on the second line as Tavares, Nylander, and, like, Jimmy fucking VC. Demonetized! EA, your voodoo always gets to me! I can't help it! Alright, well, whatever. Now, what about the power play? Four-man power play, five-man. Matthews doesn't like this coach. So the first thing we need to do is find a coach that Matthews and Marner and Tavares love. Alright, I'm starting to get it. Alright. So, leave that garbage screen. EA, we're gonna need a patch. And when you patch it, please don't delete my franchise mode, because then I'd have to start again, and I don't want to have to do that. Now, what do we got? Generalist. Kaliko. Yo, Kaliko. Christopher Kaliko. Is this, Mitch Marner's liking him. Matthews is liking him. Muzzin and Brody love his ass, but not at the defensive position. They love him at the foot. That's another problem, EA. It shows you, I might sign a coach because my defensemen love him, but they love him for the forward core. So what the hell? Don't fire this coach. Well, problem is, we need to find, all right, let me go back to the line. What was it again? We need to find a potential. For the Matthews and Marner, because that would also help the power play. So Matthews is what? Carry, dump, efficient balance, offensive strategy. So he does like what's happening on the first line. Carry, shoot, efficient balance. I need you guys to remember that. Carry, shoot, efficient balance, and he likes on the first line. Carry, shoot, efficient balance. Carry, shoot, efficient balance. Carry, shoot, efficient balance. It would be nice to be able to see players' chemistry in this screen as well. I'm just saying. And this coach's first line was what? It is behind the net. So Matthews and Marner are behind the net, carry, shoot, efficient, balanced. All right. That is what these guys like. So if we're going to try to find a coach, that's the kind of coach that we need to try to find. All right. With behind the net, forwards, Beckett, NHL head coach. Oh, they ain't nobody available. All right, we're going for an AHL coach. Hey, that's what Keith was. Jade Beckett, let's go, woman. What do you got? Behind the net, carry, shoot, efficient, balance. She's the one. She is the one, Jade Beckett. Okay. Is that the one? Behind the net, carry, shoot, efficient, balance, right? That's the one. Carry, shoot, efficient, balance, behind the net, carry. Shoot, efficient, balance, behind the net. Yep, that's the one. All right, Jade. Now, what's her power play? Her power play is umbrella. What's my power play? Because Matthews didn't like the power play. If Kaliko is umbrella, there's really no point to change it. Let's see. Overload. Oh, she is the one. All right, Kaliko, defenseman. All right, so we're gonna make some moves here. 5 years. Get the hell out of here. I know what's best for my team. Kaliko fired. Day one, GM Superbman joins the team and fires his head coach. Because I don't give a shit. Hire a coach, baby. Let's go. Kaliko. No. Beckett. All right. What was her first name? Jade? Jade, you have a tall order. The 47-year-old Jade Beckett is about to coach the Toronto Maple Leafs. Power play is A+. Penalty kill is A-. We'll work at the other shit. But look at that. Matthews and Marner absolutely love her. All right? And you know that Tavares is going to love her as well. Yeah, our power play will get going, and we'll get a pure offense, baby. Pure offense. Dumbass GM. 4-year plan, Jade. 4-year plan. NHL head coach. All right, you better sign. I'm going to pay you. You deserve it. We got to get that Austin Matthews playing at the top of his game. Yeah, 2B's in production. Man, you guys, while I'm doing this, you guys in the YouTube crowd, you should look at what the Twitch crowd is sending my way right now. They are jumping all over me for firing my head coach. But this is what I do. I mean, I created a dynasty in Seattle, and they still doubt me. It's crazy. All right, so I got Beckett on her way. Might as well simulate a few days here. Okay, Weber, you're going to be you're going to be the interim NHL head coach for right now, okay, until Beckett signs. All right, so we got the coach. We are waiting on the chemistry. We're going to have to work with the chemistry because EA Sports didn't give us a finished product. Typical. We have to sign our players still, so no, decline that trade. I'm not going through any damn free agents. I'm not trading anybody just yet, and I'm not signing any free agents. Advanced day. Come on now, baby. I want that Jade Beckett. My sources tell me your staff chemistry is excellent, so I'm hopeful that I can join the staff with little drama. I don't think that's a possibility with the first ever female head coach to coach in the NHL and to coach the Toronto Maple Leafs. That is going to be filled with drama, Jade, but I believe in your talents, all right? Do not worry. All right, so let's see what Jade brings to the table here. Coaching staff. All right, coaching staff. Jade Beckett, forwards. Woohoo! Got her signed. All right, Weber's back. We can always get better associate coaches and assistant coaches as well, but I'm just trying to figure out the chemistry to start. It's all about Matthews and Marner. I got to get these guys playing, all right? Boom. Now, what about if I go, where the hell is John Tavares? John Tavares has been scratched from Erasmus Sandin. All right, so Nylander now on the first line. I can get a +3. What about Johnny T? There it is. All right, so we have constructed the first line of the Toronto Maple Leafs for the future. I'm keeping these guys together. This will ensure that Tavares has the longest career possible. He's getting first line ice time. Matthews and Marner will be freaking just have the greatest careers ever, and these guys are going to run the show. All right, yeah, these guys, I mean, remember what I had with Lafreniere and Pressburg in Seattle? But I always used other players to grow them, right? Now I've got 3 stars, legit 90 overalls. 95, yeah, because F depth. Well, the depth is coming. Remember, if I can get crappy depth like a Jumbo Joe Thornton, for example, right? Oh, works on the second line. Beautiful, right? If I can get depth this way, Nylander's garbage. I think Nylander's going to be gone on my team. Big defenseman, maybe. Big offensive defenseman. Sorry, Nylander. And then Hyman. Let's see. Hyman. Third line. I mean, look at this. There you go. Oh, I need a sniper. That's what it is. Power forward? Hee-hee! Thornton, Simmons, and Hyman for that second line. All right, not bad depth. Nylander, third line center. That's what you did for us in Seattle. That wasn't bad. Jason Spezza. Second line playmaker. Ooh, is he better than Joe? Nope, Joe's better. Simmons. All right, cool. The important thing is we got Tavares, Matthews, and Marner that. Now, what about Riley? How does he like in this woman coach? He doesn't like the first line. Kind of likes the second line. Third line. See, here's the problem with Morgan Riley. I think I assigned a coach with offensive defenseman skills. Now, we have had players who have been two-way defenders work out on our team. So if I can find an offensive defenseman who maxes out and we get a +3 with Morgan Riley on like the first line, that might not be bad, right? But that's interesting. Morgan Riley does not work well with these guys. Now, if I go to the power play, because this was what I was hoping for, Matthews. Yeah, it works. Marner. And then we'll go, I need an offensive defenseman. Okay, so we're going to need an offensive defenseman to spark this squad, all right? Because I got Sniper. I mean, all 4 of these guys are double greens. We just need, like, what? I can't get a +5. I need an offensive defenseman. So we're going to need an offensive defenseman on this team. We're going to make a trade. What about if I go, like, a Wayne, so like a power forward? That might just still work, to be honest. Wayne Simmons. Bang. No. All right, so an offensive defenseman would be nice, but I can get myself... at least these guys going and play them all together. Like, the important thing is Marner, Matthews, Tavares, and Nylander all play on the first line power play, okay? So we can look into offensive defensemen. Penalty kill, Jaime is going to be weak. It's always weak, our penalty kill. But hey, actually, Muzzin, Riley, Brody, and okay, we have the two-way defenders that actually help out the penalty kill. That's not horrible. All right, gotcha. All right, so with that taken care of, now what we got to do is we got to free up some cap space here. So I'm just going to go to find trade. We're going to do some quick trades, all right? So my Goldie situation, we have Harold Bluetooth. We have Aaron Dell Pickle. I've got to get this $1.650 million off the books from Jack Campbell, all right? So send him out there. Damn it! There's not one team in the NHL that wants him. There's got to be. No, there's got to be. I'll trade a seventh rounder. Hang on a second. We got to get that 1.65 off our team. We have to. Yeah. I got it. Don't worry about it. I'm ready to go. Yeah. I got it, my man. Don't worry about a damn thing. All right, so Jack Campbell. Which goalie, which team needs a backup? It looks like the Anaheim Ducks want one. They already got like a 79. Let's just go through teams. Let's try to make a legit trade here. They don't need it. Buffalo don't really need it. Carter Hutton's just as good. Let's try to find a team with like somebody who's like their second goalie like 78 or worse. Then they could use it. Ooh, lots of teams have backups here. No wonder nobody wants them. Look at this. 80. Oh, that's it. That's the team. The Florida Panthers. Well, actually, they could sign Montebeau. He just hasn't been signed just yet. So now I'll give them the benefit of the doubt. They could always sign that guy. Go through. Ooh, who is that? Carey Price, 90 overall. 81 for Jared Allen. Jake Allen. Too much goddamn NBA. There it is. The New York Islanders. They got themselves Semyon Varlamov, but their backup is only 70 overall. All right, so come on. Yeah, you know you want him. For the Leafs, what we need is some sort of probably draft pick for this upcoming year. Just depth. You want to give me like a fourth for him? All right, Campbell for a fourth straight up. Will it go through? Trade rejected. All right, so that's not going to happen. How about a fifth rounder? Will that go through? Holy shit. They do not want Jack Campbell. How about a seventh? Come on. Whoa! Okay, so the trading is different in this. I got to get him off the team, though. I have to. So I'll give you a fifth from next year. All right, Jack Campbell and a fifth from next year. Take it. There it is. Take him off my team, all right? Jesus, I don't want him. I gotta free up the damn cap. All right, everyone's saying fleece, bad trade, whatever, man. Don't you understand the salary cap's about to kick in once preseason's over? I still gotta sign Travis Dermott, and I gotta try to sign all these guys. Shut the hell up. Defenseman. All right, so we got Riley, we got Muzzin, Brody. Hall I can keep for now in this system. All right, so let's bring up Bogosian. I'll bring up Liljegren for right now. All right, what do you guys think should be our top six? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I mean, these should. What do you guys think about Liljegren? Where should I be playing Liljegren this year? His role is minor league top two defenseman. Where should he go? Back to the AHL for a year? Or should I give him the chance? Don't know about his chemistry. AHL? AHL? All right, so everyone is saying that Lily should be in the AHL for another year, so I'll send him down there. Marinson. I'll bring up Marinson right now just for the depth. All right, that makes sense. Usually the Leafs, you have him as the seventh defenseman. So Riley, Muzzin, Brody, Hull, Sandin, Bogosian, and Marinson. Those will be my seven defensemen. Yeah, that looks good. And then the forward core, just got to bring up somebody else. Baton, Agostino, Korshkov, Robertson. Let's bring up Robert. 74 overall, you think? Playmaker? Carry, shoot, balance? No, he's not going to work out on any line. So he can play in the AHL for right now. So I'll bring him up. Paton, power forward, playmaker. Doesn't work on any line. Agostino, two-way forward. Korshkov, power forward. Ooh, hell yeah, I could use you. Get your ass up here. All right, so I will edit the AHL lines, ladies and gentlemen. Do not worry. We will take care of that. We're going to take care of everything. This is video number one, though. We've just got to start the series up in the right way. So the scratch players, we got Korshkov, Marinson, and Bogosian now. All right, so other than that, now we have to sign the RFAs. I just don't know how much cap space we're going to have for these guys. So if I need to still make some trades, I think Pierre Engvall is somebody that I can move on from. Johnny, you were looking at the AHL chemistry. Oh, yeah, was I? My bad. We'll bring him up after. But let me just see this. The RFAs. All right. So Travis Dermott, how much cap space do we have? Okay. So we have no cap space to sign these players. So what are we going to do with Travis Dermott? We either have to trade him right now, and same thing with Ilya Mikheyev. All right. No cap space. 1.4 he wants. No cap space. Anderson. I can get Anderson to a nice cheap deal, so I can bring him in. And then goaltenders, nobody. So we got three players that we got to sign, but we have no cap space, right? You're so effed. Well, we could always start this series with a bang, and that bang to free up some cap space would be William Nylander. It's as simple as that. William freaking Nylander. All right. Now with our new head coach, we know that William Nylander does not work out. Tavares, Matthews, and Marner all had different chemistry. And now with our new head coach, look, William Nylander does not fit anywhere, right? Now, if I'm going to be trading Nylander, it's going to be straight up for an offensive defenseman. So we can free up that $6 million. We'd have to get a cheap offensive defenseman, which would then allow us to sign Mikheyev, Dermott, and the third guy, right? So let's go to player search and see what kind of offensive defensemen are available. Find trade, player search. I know it sucks to trade away William Nylander, but the Leafs have been losing, you know, four first-round exits in a row. Washington, Boston. Actually, Columbus wasn't even the first round, right? We didn't even make the fucking playoff. Damn it! Stop swearing, you dirty sailor, you. It's a sign of unintelligence. God, you just use your vocabulary and find something else. Defenseman. All right, here we go. A player role. Any role's fine by me. And offensive defenseman. All right, Jake Bean? Could you imagine? Well, what we might want to do is use our scouts first before we make the trade for William Nylander. We can always start the year, right? Because we want to make sure that the guys work on our line. So you know what? Might want to go out and get some good scouts. But if we go down through the list, right? Erik Karlsson, we're not getting Erik Karlsson. More importantly than overall in value, it's the salary cap and the years. We're looking at these two, right? So 11.5 times 7? Hell no. Brent Burns, 8 times 5? Hell no. Klingberg, that ain't bad. But why would Dallas trade away Klingberg when they just went to the Stanley Cup final, right? Torrey Krug, just signing with St. Louis. Quinn Hughes, not getting him. Captain Keith Yandel, ain't getting him. Dougie Hamilton. Now, that's an interesting one, but the money goes from Nylander into Hamilton, and then you don't get those RFAs signed, right? You're still in the same situation. And Coach Christopher Kalika. Okay, so I have to send my scouts out once again. Yeah, I definitely have to. Cale Makar, Colorado would not trade them. Falk, he's on St. Louis. Gosh, Despier, 3 years left at 4.5. Now, if you can make the argument for Shane Gosh, Despier to leave Philadelphia, that could be one, right? That $4.5 million is a nice contract. Neil Pionk, 1 year left at 3. I don't think the Winnipeg Jets would want to get rid of more defensemen for wingers. Shattenkirk, no. Adam Fox from the Rangers will be really nice, but why would the Rangers move on from him? A young team just drafting Alexei Lafreniere. They need to keep those young guys. The best guy so far is Gosh Despier, to be honest. Sammy Vatanen, 1 year. What the hell? Oh, he hasn't signed. He's a free agent. Wait a minute. Sammy Vatanen's a free agent. Okay. Interesting. I wonder how much he would want. A right-handed defenseman as well. Because then you could thing is, I wanted to use Nylander to acquire a real good, but then you could use Nylander to acquire another depth player and just sign the guy in free agency. Interesting. Okay, I'll check out free agency after this. Justin Schultz, 2 years. Did he just sign with Washington? I think so. Alex Goligoski, no. Tony D'Angelo just signed with the Rangers, so no. Samuel Gerrard, long extension. Ethan Bear from the Edmonton Oilers. Oilers are looking for wingers for Connor McDavid and Leon Draisaitl, but they need defense as well. I think you could make an argument to make a trade there with Ethan Bear and William Nylander, something along those lines. Calvin DeHaan, Grizzlick. Hunt, Sakara, Bockfist, Shillington, and we start to get down here into the lower numbers. Evan Bouchard. So we'd have to take a chance on one of these players. So I wouldn't be trading away, what's his name? I would not be trading away William Nylander just yet. We could probably start the season with William Nylander, make a trade somewhere around December or January once we get our scouts. And we can actually take a look at our scouts right now, right? Jake Bean, no, we can't just copy what we did with the Seattle Stallions. right? So when I look at my scouts, I got an NHL Pacific, Central, Metro, Atlantic good, AHL Pacific, Central, North, Atlantic good, WHL, OHL, QMJHL, two in America, Dell, SHL, the Liga, and Russia. So we have all the scouts that we need. I'm going to try to see if there's any more good, if there are any good scouts available overall. Nobody. All right, so since there are no scouts available, I will just sign a couple of guys. Yeah, just sign a couple of guys from like the OHL. Just to get this one guy, McCabe, offer contract. Kurt McCabe. We'll go the WHL because I got three more scouts. Let's just completely scout the CHL for a year and see if we can get something lucky in the later rounds. And this guy's Jaguar. All right, Yves Jaguar. So we're going to sign those three scouts. Our NHL scouts are already doing their job. What we need to do now is actually assign the scouts. I'll show you guys how we do that. So assign scout. No, actually, how can we do this? No. Hang on. Player search. Yeah, I can just do it from the watch list, right? Yeah. So watch this. Position, defenseman. All right, player role. We're going to go Annie. Offensive defenseman. Where's the salary? Can I get the salary? Yes. Salary max. So we don't want to go above, let's say, we don't want to go above $4 million, right? Because that will make it a lot less. And the age, we don't want anyone above the age of 29. We got to stay on that let's say 27, because we got to stay on like a four-year plan. All right? So those are the kind of defensemen that I want. And now we can really target them. So I'm just going to sort by overall right here, right? Quinn Hughes, Makar, no. Pionk, I will scout him because you never know. You could maybe make a trade happen there. So how do I do it? Player info. Scout player. There it is. Full. All right, so we're gonna scout Neil Pionk to see if he's a good fit for the Toronto Maple Leafs, all right? Adam Fox, I wouldn't say they trade Adam Fox. We're not going to do that. Ethan Bear, we are going to scout him. All right, so complete for Ethan Bear. We're going to see if we can attract Ethan Bear to our squad. Bockfist, his trade value is way too high, so we're not going to do that. Shillington is about a perfect guy because you could grow him with 1 year left. Shillington would be nice. So we're going to scout him. All right, Swedish defenseman. DeJuice, 26, high top six. It's not bad. Evan Bouchard, he's just got no room to grow. Yeah, he doesn't have a lot of room to grow, but I'll still try him out. Scout player. There you go, buddy. All right, Evan Bouchard, we're going to scout you as well. Very nice. Jake Bean, we'll scout him. We'll see what he can do. Brandstrom, no. Forsling, top six. Yeah, that's something. He could be something. And if I could get a trade with William Nylander and I pick up one of these guys and then somebody else on the team, that could be real useful for us. Aho, 24, medium top six. Yeah, scout him as well. Get him done. We're going to need to find these guys, especially for the AHL squad. Gregor, Carrier. Who's this? Bedwin. Hell yeah. Try him out. All right. So we are sending our scout out. Dursey. He was already on the Leafs, wasn't he? Drysdale. Jamie Drysdale. Ooh. Let's try that. See if maybe halfway through the season they want to trade him for some reason. Merkley. Ryan Merkley, 66 medium elite. Jesus. Cale Addison, top four. Hell yeah. Now these guys are way down there, but they still have that potential, right? So it would take a while for them to grow, but still something that we can absolutely use. All right, so that's enough. That is enough for our players. They're going to be scouted. When we come back, we can just put in those same stats, find the defenseman, and then possibly make the trade, all right? We can also go after a defensive defenseman. I don't know which kind of defensemen are going to work on this team. I don't think it's the same kind of a coach that we had with the Seattle Stallions, right? So there it is, ladies and gentlemen. We have the Toronto Maple Leafs started up for year number one. We fired our coach. We've already put William Nylander on the trading block. What we have to do is edit our lines, get the season underway, but I want to see what you guys have to say when it comes to potential trades, all right? Again, I'll show you what our assets are and what we have. We have our first rounder for this year and for next year. So if we want to take a big splash with William Nylander and a first, we can. We got to sign Frederik Andersen to an extension if we can do that. We got to free up the cap space so that we can sign our RFAs and such. All right. And then the forward core. If we're going to put Tavares, Marner, and Matthews together, we're going to need to find some depth. So do we play our young guns? Do we play our older players? We got to get these RFAs, guys. We need Mikheyev back on the team. We definitely do. We need Dermott, we need Mikheyev, and we need to trade Nylander for one of those lower defensemen, grow him, and then maybe also bring in like a middle six center with that William Nylander trade. I'm telling you, lots of moves that we need to do here, ladies and gentlemen. And to close it off, we will show you free agency, because... What? Oh, they're RFAs, right? You're telling me that freaking Barzal and Dubois still haven't been signed in this just? Ooh, give them offer sheets, ladies and gentlemen, free agents. Well, team's interested, so they have offered them a contract, all those 1 years. So they are getting those contracts now. I'm looking for the unrestricted free agents, though. I was like, shit, did I just do this whole start and the rosters are screwed up? Please, God, no. So Hasselhoffman still hasn't signed, only wants a one-year deal. Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo. Although we can't now. We're struggling for money as it is. Vatanen only wants 2.4. Vatanen only wants 2.4, ladies and gentlemen. So again, we do not know his... Is any team interested? No teams are interested in him right now. Can I scout the player? I can't scout him because why? Because he's in free agency. So there's no way to scout him. I don't know if he's a good offensive defenseman or not. I could sign him to a one-year deal, but we'd have to trade away William Nylander, all right? So again, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to leave you here with the contract screen. We already traded away our second highest paid goaltender in Campbell. These are the salaries that we have. Can't trade. $7 million. If we can move on from that, we can free up a lot of cap. Muzzin, we got to hold on to. Riley, we got to hold on to at least for a year. Brody, we can trade away Kerfoot, but we need depth, right? So you're not going to get too much better with 3.5 at 81 overall. So if we want to trade Kerfoot, there's $10 million that we can free up. Justin Hall, Pierre Engvall, but we got to keep that kind of contract on the team. So there's the potential to free up like $10 million of salary, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know what you think, because GM Superb Man is about to make some major decisions, and I want to make sure both the Twitch scouts and the YouTube scouts are on board before we start up year number one. So let me know what you guys think. And I will see you in episode number 2. Hey guys, Johnny here, and thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, give us a like, hit that subscribe button, and make sure notifications are on so you don't miss out on any new content. We also live stream on Twitch, where I take days off my life for your entertainment. Sonny Gray, get out of it.
You stupid pieces of shit! I should have gone with Jose for Fernandez! Oh my God, pitching change. Fernandez, get your ass in there. Oh, I swear to God, baseball God just decided to all over me. Grand slam. Oh, yeah. Make me miss the playoffs with a first-ranked team. Year two, 30 games above 500. No divisional win. Trip to the wild card. First inning.